The Natural Sciences and Engineering Research Council supports students at all stages of their post-secondary education. This video will provide information about NSERC's programs for undergraduate students. Keep in mind that this is intended as an overview only. For more details, you should read the complete program description and instructions for completing an application. To apply for an Undergraduate Student Research Award from NSERC, go to the homepage on the NSERC website. Select Online Services from the left-hand menu, or select Login from the bottom left of any page on the site. We strongly recommend that you review the instructions for Form 202, Application for an Undergraduate Student Research Award. You can find the instructions by selecting the PDF Forms and Instructions link. Remember that this tutorial is intended as an overview and will not cover every aspect of completing this form. If you have questions that are not answered by the information on our website, contact NSERC's Online Services Help Desk. If you are a previous user, log into the site. Otherwise, register as a first-time user. On the eConsole page, choose Forms, Student. Next, select Form 202, Part 1. After you create a file, you can close and reopen it as often as you wish. Keep in mind that the system will log you out without saving the content of the current page after a period of inactivity. The left side of the screen shows a list of the various pages to be completed. As each page comes up, enter the appropriate information. Refer to the instructions as you need to. The PIN referred to in this page is assigned to you by NSERC. If you have submitted an application in the past and don't remember your PIN, contact the Online Services Help Desk. Return to the eConsole page and enter your PIN. It will then appear automatically in the Person Profile page. If this is your first application to NSERC, leave this field blank. Your PIN is not your social insurance number, student number, or the reference number provided by the online system. Some of the information requested here, such as your status as a visible minority or disabled person, is used for statistical and administrative purposes only. Please enter your current mailing address and contact information. It is very important to notify NSERC of any changes by email or telephone. Any updates you make through the online system after an application has been submitted will not be associated with that application. When entering information about your academic background, please do not include programs that you have not yet started. On this page, list any awards that you have received, including previous awards from NSERC. Identify which transcripts will be submitted. Your transcripts must be scanned and uploaded as a single combined file, including a copy of the university legend for each set of transcripts. It should be formatted as a black and white printed document, and where possible, in portrait style. Only the portions of your transcript that reflect your academic record need to be included. If you are successful in the competition, you may be asked to submit the official copies for verification before you take up your award. If your transcripts are in a language other than English or French, they must be translated and certified. You have now completed entering your information. Select the Portfolio menu item to continue. You should make a note of the reference number assigned to your application. You will need to give it to your proposed supervisor or host organization contact person so they can complete Part 2 of the application. This page allows you to verify that Part 1 of your application is complete. Correct the errors listed on the verification report and re-verify. When your verification report shows that your application is complete, submit it electronically to your university or host organization and forward your reference number to your proposed supervisor or host organization contact person. This concludes the student's portion of the application. Your proposed supervisor or host organization contact person must complete Part 2 of the application. The proposed supervisor or host organization contact person must log in or register. Then select Forms Researcher to complete Part 2 of the application. From this page, select Form 202, Part 2. If the student is applying for a USRA for industry at a host organization that is not currently eligible, the organization must also complete Form 183B. This form can be found by selecting PDF Forms and Instructions on the Online Services entry page. The supervisor enters information related to the project on this page, including the reference number assigned to the student when completing Part 1 of this application. The research subject code should be used to give a broad view of the project that the student will be working on. The supervisor should enter his or her own profile and employment information on the next two pages. Enter the address on this page where the student will be doing research for the 16-week work term. The outline of the proposed research project and the student's role must be written by the proposed supervisor. Both sections should be written in plain language. Select the portfolio menu item to verify that this part of the application is complete and correct any errors that are identified. To complete the process, the proposed university supervisor or the contact person at the host organization must go to the My Portfolio page and select Verify to ensure that all the required information has been entered. Once the verification is complete, the status of the application will be changed to Final. It is important to note that NSERC will not accept changes to the application once it has been submitted. The proposed university research supervisor must submit the form to the USRA liaison officer at the university by selecting Submit to LO. USRA liaison officers then submit electronically to NSERC the applications selected for awards by their institution. Completed applications from host organizations must be submitted electronically to NSERC only by the designated contact person at that organization by selecting Submit to NSERC. If you have questions, please refer back to the instructions or other documents on our website, or contact us directly.